Hello, and welcome to Virtual Sunday School. This week, we have a very special guest who's going to help us with our reading that comes from John 3. And we've been hearing John 3 for the whole year because our verse of the year is, "For God so loved the world." And I hear that, and I think that's kind of a cliffhanger. Do you know what a cliffhanger is? It means when you're sort of on the edge of your seat and you want to know the rest of the story. I've been waiting to hear the rest of the story, and we're going to get to hear it now. And we're going to hear, "God so loved the world that." And so listen to this reading by our guest reader, Catherine, and see what you think the answer is.
"And just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the wilderness, so must the Son of Man be lifted up, that whoever believes in him may have eternal life. For God so loved the world that he gave his only Son, so everyone who believes in him may not perish, but have eternal life. Indeed, God did not send the Son into the world to condemn the world, but in order that the world might be saved through him. Those who believe in him are not condemned, but those who do not believe are condemned already because they have not believed in the name of the only Son of God. And this is the judgment, that the light has come into the world, and people loved the darkness rather than the light because their deeds were evil. For all who do evil hate the light and do not come to the light so that their deeds may not be exposed. But those who do what is true come to the light so that it may be clearly seen that their deeds have been done in God."
Thank you, Catherine. That was fantastic. So we hear what? What did we hear? What does that mean? God so loved the world that he gave us the roadmap to eternal life. That's pretty neat. And so when we talk about that roadmap, first of all, what's the first thing? Catherine, did you hear the first thing? We have to believe, right? We have to believe. And all those who believe in God have the gift of eternal life. And so that's number one. And now number two, it says that he gave his Son, and it was not to condemn. Our sins, we all have sins, right? And so if we were being condemned, God would be saying to us, "Get your act together, people. What are you doing?" But he's not doing that. He's not angry at us, telling us that we're wrong. He's saying, "I know you sin, and Jesus did what?" Catherine, do you know what Jesus did?
Yeah, he died for us.
And to forgive our sins. So we all receive forgiveness because of that. So we are saved because of that. So that is pretty cool. And then the last thing that I heard is really crucial to the whole reading. And that is, those who do good basically have no problem hiding what they do because they're doing good things and they can do it out in the light and show everybody. So if you're following God's word and trying very hard to reconcile any sins and to receive that forgiveness, then you can keep doing everything you do out in the light. But sometimes people who don't want their deeds to be seen are doing things sort of in secret or not in the light because maybe they're not doing the right thing and they're a little bit scared and they're hiding it. So I think it's kind of silly though to hide, right? Because we're all forgiven. So even if we've done something wrong and we want to hide it, we can come into the light and be forgiven. That's a huge gift. And we celebrate this gift every year. Do you know when we celebrate it? There's a hint behind me. What day was this? This was 2 years ago, the picture. We were all in church and we see an Alleluia. So that's a clue because we don't say that during Lent. And there's some lilies here that are very specific to a certain day. And looks like some people who are dressed up in some really nice outfits. Catherine, what day do you think this was?
Is it Easter?
It's Easter. Yes, we celebrate this Bible verse on Easter because God gave us the great gift and it's proven true when Jesus rises on Easter. So think about that as you go through your week about this great gift that we've been given. And even if you mess up a little bit, that we are forgiven and we can come back into the light and keep trying to do a little bit better. And we celebrate that. So thank you for joining. And thank you to our guest speaker today, Catherine. And we look forward to seeing you again next week.